Hello guys, welcome to ITS, Information Technology Skills. So for today's video, kakontinue po natin yung flowchart and algorithm sample problems. But for today, we're going to have decisions and conditions. Okay, so this is the lesson 3.2 of our introduction to computer program. Now let's start. So, ang conditional statement, guys, these are statements that results to true or false. Okay? So, usually used on decision blocks. So, yung conditional statements will be discussed on a separate video. Now, we have two types of statements in flowchart. We have the single alternative selection structure. So, pag sinabi natin single alternative selection structure. Okay, so if you're going to look at the flowchart here, pwedeng yung isa lang ang may action. So, hindi ibig sabihin na kapag conditions, true or false yung results niya, yung dalawang yun, meron kang gagawin. Okay? So, pwedeng yung isa lang may gagawin ka, yung isa, wala kang gagawin. So, may either be true or either false, depending on the conditions or actions na gagawin mo sa process mo. The next, we also have the dual alternative selection structure. Performs two different things when the condition is true or false. Okay? So, opposite lang po to no una kanina. So, dito naman guys, meron kang actions sa true mo, meron ka ding action kapag nag-false yung statement mo. Okay? Kaya po siya tinawag na dual alternative. Both conditions, either true or false, meron kang action na gagawin. Okay? So, yung block po dyan, hindi lang po process block. May either be another condition or input or output block. Okay? So, let's have an example. Example number 1, draw a flowchart that will ask the user to enter a character indicating the user's gender. If the user enter M, display you're a male. Okay? So now, for the algorithm. Kailangan natin guys, dun sa statement natin, ask the user to enter a character indicating the user. So andyan po yung statement na yan. Ano ibig sabihin yan? You need to get the user's gender. Okay? So, after getting the user's gender, ano ang kailangan nung problem natin? Ano nakalagay sa statement? If the user enter M, display you're a male. So, paano natin malalaman na in-enter niya is M? Okay? As if the gender is M. So, ibig sabihin, tatanungin natin, gagawa tayo ng decisions or condition. Kapag in-enter niya is M, you're going to display male. So, pag na-enter daw niya yung M, display, you're a male. Meron pa ba siyang ibang kailangan? Okay? So, wala na po siyang ibang kailangan. That's the end algorithm. Now, let's turn it into a flowchart. Now, let's have the flowchart. Of course, we need the terminal block start. Then next, initialization block. Inside the initialization block, we have the word gender. So, bakit kailangan natin ilagay yung gender dyan? Because later on, mag-i-enter si user ng gender niya. And saan po natin siya ilalagay? Or we are stating that the word gender will be needed soon dun sa flowchart natin. Okay, so kapag na-enter na, nakalagay na po tayo ng initialization block. Next is to get the gender. So yun po yung nasa algorithm natin kanina. After getting the gender, ask if the gender is M, sabi niya. So anong gagawin natin kapag ask? From the word ask, you're going to use decision block. Is gender equals to M? Okay? So, kapag true daw siya, guys, anong gagawin? display your email. After displaying, meron pa po siyang nailagay doon. Wala na po guys. So, it means that it ends the flowchart. So, paano naman po pag false? Wala naman po siyang nakalagay na gagawin if the condition is false. So, it terminates the program directly kapag false or hindi po M ang in-enter ni user. Okay, so this is an example of single alternative structure. Okay, or you can have this flowchart. Okay, so if you're going to observe, diretso po yung flowchart. If the statement is true, print, then diretso na exit. Asan po yung false? Okay, so if there is no activity sa false, you can write it like this. Okay, the next we have example number 2. Draw a flowchart that will ask the user to enter a character indicating the user's gender. If the user enter M, display you're a male. If not, assume that the user is female, thus display you're a female. Okay, so now let's try to write the algorithm. Of course, we need to get the user's gender. Okay, next, alagay dyan. If the user enters M, display you're a male. If not, assume that the user is female, thus display you're a female. So, paano natin malalaman? Of course, we need to decide. M ba yung in-enter niya or hindi M? Pag M, display you're a male. Pag hindi daw siya M, i-assume natin na yung gumagamit or the user is a female. So, ipiprint po natin is you're a female. So, the algorithm will be decide for the gender. So, how do we do that? Of course, we need to use decision block. So, sabi niya, if M, display you're a male. If not, assume that the user is female. Display you're a female. Okay, so that is the algorithm. Now, let's turn it into a flowchart. Of course, we need the terminal block start, initialization block, gender. We are indicating that we need the word gender later on the flowchart. Okay, then next, get the gender as needed. Then ask if the gender is M. If the gender is M, sabi niya, print your email. After printing your email, it will go directly to terminal block. If the gender is not M, that is false condition, anong gagawin niya? Print your a female. Okay, so pwedeng A, B, C, D, except M. We are assuming that the user is a female. So, we're going to print your a female. Okay, so this is an example of dual alternative selection. Okay? So, now we have example number 3. Create a flowchart that asks the user to enter 2 numbers. Display true if the first number is greater than the second number. Otherwise, display false. Now, let's try to write the algorithm. It says there, ask the user to enter 2 numbers. It means that we need to enter 2 numbers, namely num1 for the first number and num2 for the second number. After entering 2 numbers, display true if the first number is greater than the second number. Otherwise, display false. So, how do we do that? Of course, we need to compare the 2 numbers. Okay? So, to compare that, we need num1 greater than num2. Okay? So, if the statement is true, display true. if the statement says num1 is less than the num2, display false. Okay? So, ganyan po siya, guys. Now, convert po natin into flowchart. Okay, of course, we need the terminal block start. Then next, the initialization block num1 and num2. So, bakit ngayon dalawa na siya? Because kailangan po natin yung num1 and num2 later on dun sa flowchart natin. And the value of num1 and num2 may differ depending on the user's input. Depende po kung ano in-enter ni user. Okay, so now let's get the value from the user. We need the input block, get num1, then get num2. After entering the value of num1 and num2, we need to compare. So, for the comparison, we need decision block. Okay, inside the decision block, we have the question, is num1 greater than num2? Okay, that is the comparison. So, if num1 is greater than num2, it will print true. After printing the word true, it will go directly to terminal block N. If the condition is false, which means that num2 is greater than num1, it will print false. Okay? So, that is the flowchart. Then now, let's go with example number 4. Okay, so for example number 4, we're going to use multiple conditions. Okay, so ibig sabihin, gagamit po tayo ng 2 or more conditions. Create a flowchart that asks the user to enter a number from 1 to 3. If 1 is entered, print hello. If 2 is entered, print hi. If 3 is entered, then print bye. Okay, so for the algorithm, the first is you need to enter a number from 1 to 3. Okay? So, instruction number 1, enter a number. So, sorry for the typo errors. Hindi ko na po na-edit yung numbers. Okay? That is without S. Sorry. The next, after entering the number, you need to decide or select the value of the number. 1 ba siya? 2 ba siya? Or 3? Okay? So, on the statement above, nakalagay po dyan, if 1 is entered, print hello. So, that is the instruction number 3. The next, if 2 is entered, print hi. That is the next instruction. If 3 is entered, print bye. That is the next instruction. Now, if we're going to turn it into flowchart, okay, we need to terminal block start. The next, initialization block num. Okay, so we have initialization, of course. The next there is the input block. Inside the input block, we have get num. Okay, the value of num may either be 1, 2, or 3. So how do we identify if the value of num is 1, 2, or 3? Of course, we need to use decision block. Okay, the first condition is you're going to ask if the value of num is equal to 1. If it is 1, print hello. After printing hello, it will go directly to n. If the value is not 1, it may either be 2. Thus, you're going to ask, tatanungin mo na naman siya, is num equals to 2? Kasi hindi po siya 1. So, baka 2 po siya. Pag true siya, print hi. So, pag na-print na po niya yung hi, mag-e-end na po siya. Ay, paano kung hindi siya 1? Hindi siya 2? Baka 3. So, tanungin ulit natin siya. Is num equals to 3? If that is true, print bye. Okay, so after printing bye, it will end. Paano naman kapag hindi siya 1, hindi siya 2, hindi siya 3? If you're going to look at the part of 3, the third conditions or decision block, true lang meron siya. Wala siya for the false. So, pag hindi po siya 3, let's say nag-enter si user ng 4. And 4 is wala po sa pagpipilian. Wala pong gagawin yung system. Okay? The flowchart will not do anything. Kasi wala po siya sa pagpipilian. Now, let's revise the example number 4. So, kanina, paano yung wala sa pagpipilian? So, we added here. Otherwise, print invalid. So, we're going to add the algorithm. If not, wala po siya sa pagpipilian, hindi po siya 1, hindi po siya 2, hindi po siya 3, display invalid. Okay? So, let's see sa flowchart. So, ito po yung original na flowchart kanina. So, paano pag hindi siya 1, hindi siya 2, hindi din siya 3? So, ibig sabihin wala siya sa pagpipilian. So, ang gagawin mo daw, you're going to print invalid. So, pag nag-false po lahat ng to, ang mangyayari, we're going to add at the bottom of the last condition or decision block. So, pag false po yan, print invalid. After printing invalid, it will go directly to end. Okay? So, that's it guys. It ends the session for today. So, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more tutorial videos. Bye!